apartment complex getting some unwanted visitors.
Yeah, our Meredith Hilgartner joins us from the Kentwood Apartments on Avenue Q with the details.
Terry and David, you might be wondering why I'm holding this trash can and wearing this glove. Well, these are two of Alicia Flores' most important tools, coming out here every morning, picking up from the illegal activity that's been going on here at the Kentwood Apartments overnight.
I'm having to pick up condoms every morning, which is an ugly thing to do. They'll come over here and urinate in front of their doors, my tenants' doors, or they'll use a number two.
Alicia Flores can't keep up with all the work. He took over as the manager of the Kentwood Apartments 3 years ago and renovated the complex top to bottom.
I've managed to turn this place around, get this place back to life, bring good families here. Everybody here works, and all my tenants are good tenants.
But Flores says his handiwork is going to waste because he can't stop the illegal activity.
And that's basically everything I see on my cameras all day is the prostitution and the homeless.
His security cameras came in handy Monday morning, catching an altercation in the back parking lot after Flores caught two people having sexual relations in their car.
It was a black male with a white female, and they were having their thing in the car. And I asked him, I said, sir, you know what, you cannot be doing that here. You need to get out of here. He immediately got out of his car and came at me with a knife.
Resident Irene Hernandez watched the fight unfold from her front door.
So I thought they were going to fight. So I went ahead and called the cops, you know.
Flores says LPD responded. The man and woman were already gone, but Flores still had his video and pictures.
I got everything on record.
Now Flores hopes LPD will step up patrol in the area.
We just need the help of the city. We need the help of the police officers to come here, patrol more of the area. Pay attention, know that, you know what, you know, we are here.
Flores says he's going to request a permit from the city so he can build a large fence on the backside of this alleyway. He says he also plans on adding a couple of gates to the complex so basically he can separate the apartments from the rest of the neighborhood. In Central Lubbock, I'm Meredith Hilgartner, KLBK News.
Now, we asked Lubbock police what kind of calls they've gotten to the complex, and they said they've had 6 calls in the last month. 2 assaults, 1 drunk driver, but no calls for prostitution.